Yo guys, it's basically Nigabro here, and many people have been asking, how do you do moving blocks? And if you don't know what they are, it's basically the thing that I did in Preston Escape. I'm gonna show some clips right now.
We have to push it this way! How am I supposed to do that and not die? I have a feeling I'm supposed to die.
But how do I do them? And now it's really hard to explain, and that's why I created a little generator that will create them for you. Naturally, I will explain how it works, so you can create some yourself, but this is a one command block structure. In fact, I have all of the command right here. Look at that. It's so long that when I paste it, it lags. But yeah, I have all of the command right there, and, you know, it's gonna be out for the download in the description, so check it out. But today, I'm gonna show you what is the command and what it does, and also, you know, how to make it. But first, let's show off what it does, because seriously, guys, it's really amazing. Please leave a like, I need it. So let's create a new word, just a random new word, and let's paste the command in, and you're gonna see what happens. Basically, every single block will become pushable, so you will be able to push every single block as long as there is not another block above it, and not above it, sorry, you know, in front of it, or something like, I don't even know. But we're gonna paste the command, always active, and as you can see, it works, and I'm inside of it, okay, that's cool. And as you can see, I have this little command thingies right here. Spawn moving block, you move every block, you stop moving every block, and you get more items. So basically, you get more items, basically gives you more items, you know, it's pretty straightforward. But now Minecraft is really normal. The thing is, if you place a block right here, and you put spawn moving block, as you can see, this block is now gonna have some particles. And this means that when I move, when I go nearby the block moves, but only if there is air. So right here it cannot move, so you know, now we can move, so it's something like that. But there is also a command, this one, to make you move every single block, which is literally insane, and I'm gonna do it right now. Boom, and now I move every single block. If there is another person on the server, he's not gonna be able to move it. It's only the person that executes the little server fish, okay? And I made that so that people wouldn't grieve so much, if that makes sense. Also, now I have a particle above me to show that I can break every block. I mean, I can move every block. So as you can see now, every single block moves, even grass. And now these blocks are not affected by gravity, though. Only sand and gravel are. And instead, this block right here, an example. Oh my gosh, I spawned the bottom one, as you can see, like this. If we make a little bit of a fall, like that. Oh my gosh, why is there water? Okay, now I can move everything. So wait, let's stop moving every block. And as you can see now, I don't have the particle anymore, and nothing happens. But if I place a block right here, I do a moving block, and then I just push it over this side. As you can see, it's gonna get teleported downwards, and if I do it again, it's gonna get teleported. Wait, where did it go? Oh, I pushed it inside. I was afraid the map was bugged. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh yeah, and that's another thing I just showed you without even meaning it. This video is actually going great, don't worry about it. But basically, if you spawn the block, as you can see, it's gonna go down here, okay? But then, if you wanna remove the moving block, just push, you know, just destroy it, and the block is gonna get removed. It's really cool, and simple, and straightforward, hopefully. Guys, it took me a day to make. Please leave a like, just do it, please. Okay, so as you can see, the structure is like so big, oh my gosh, so many commands that went into this. But it was really fun, okay? Yeah, of course. And now I'm gonna show you actually, you know, some of the commands, and basically the normal, the straightforward stuff, and yeah. So these are the commands that you saw in the structure before, but they are kinda laid out, and I also put some comments, so you can understand them better. I'm gonna leave the download of this word, as well as the command, in the description, and I also gonna, you know, ask some YouTubers to play the map and see how they do in the every block moving challenge, and maybe LogoZip could showcase it, I don't know, we will see. Notice me, senpai. But yeah, so basically this is the init. It basically means that are the commands that are gonna, you know, work only once, and basically what it does is the game's rules, command block output false, so you don't get spammed, and also set the word spawn. It's some pretty simple stuff. This is the first thing. Basically what it does is that when a silverfish is on the ground, a tagged silverfish is on the ground, it will summon an area effect cloud that basically is the moving block. So when I do, you know, when I spawn the silverfish that creates a moving block, basically it will summon an area effect cloud, and now it will just detect if I'm on the left of the area effect cloud, and if I am, it's gonna clone the block inside the area effect cloud to the right, and so on for every single direction. Also, I did a thing, and I executed it the block below the area effect cloud is air, and if it is, then the block gets cloned one block below, and also the area effect cloud gets TP'd one block below. So, you know, that's how gravity works, basically. And yeah, so these are all of those commands. Also, there is the particle, of course. I mean, nothing really interesting. Oh yeah, and also if the block inside the area effect cloud is air, then the area effect cloud will die. So it's like you destroyed it. Now, these are the items. Okay, this is supposed to be a get item sign, but I didn't do the sign anymore because I didn't feel like it. No, I'm just kidding, because freaking Mr. Gretto didn't work. I don't know why. I used Mr. Gretto as a command block generator, combiner, and it just stopped working. Like, it said, no, I'm not doing signs for you. That's why I decided to add the get more items, you know, item, so you can just drop that and get more if you need. And okay, so these are all the items. Basically, they're just, you know, spawn eggs that spawn custom mobs that actually have the moving block tag or the other tags, okay? And instead, these are the commands for every single block, for, you know, the thing where you move every single block. So it will always detect if there is the block mover. No, wait, the block mover is you, actually. You are the block mover. So basically, when you do, when you drop this silverfish, okay, this spawn egg, the second one, you will basically get a tag. What is it? It's right here. Okay, yeah, right here. When you drop it, this removes the tag. I think it's this one that adds it. Okay, so when you drop it, okay, I mean when you summon it, you will get a tag, and only the closest person will get a tag, so only the person who summons the mob, and then the mob will die, like before. But when you, and this tag will make you able to move every single block. So the same thing that you did to only this block will be possible for every single block, and this is how it works. And then, you know, the third egg just, you know, it's the opposite. It just removes the tag and also kill, you know, it doesn't kill you, it kills the item, yeah. I mean, the silverfish. And these are all the commands. This is just the same line as this one. Basically, when you press on get more items, I mean, when you summon the get more items mob, basically this line will activate, giving you all the items again. So this is part of the init, I guess. So all of these commands, you could put them in the init, and all of these commands, you could put them in this line if you only want to do two lines. And yeah, guys, this was it for today's video. It was pretty, like, literally so amazing to make. I saw online, I didn't see a lot of people making some contraptions like this, so I was like, I have to make one like this. It would be a really fun challenge. And no, it really was. I must say the truth, in 1.13, it would have been simpler to make, but, you know, I really want to use, like, this version, because 1.13 is still a snapshot. But perhaps when 1.13 releases, I'm gonna update it to that, so you can look forward to that too. Anyways, dudes, I hope you really enjoyed this video, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one. Actually, though, no, you actually have to leave a like, please do. I'm crying right now, please do.